Hello, and welcome to the fourth video in the American Portfolio's 9 Points Investment Management Impact Investing Series. I'm Jessica Skolnick, and with me today is David Jakansky. In our last video, we talked about how interested investors are in impact investing, especially women and younger investors.
Today, we'll look at the opportunity those clients represent in today's marketplace and how winning their business now could pay dividends for the future success of your practice. In previous episodes, we've talked about impact investing, but we're going to take a slight detour to discuss the types of clients who are most interested in this type of investing. That is, millennials and women, and why they're the two demographics you can't afford to ignore.
Millennials get written off by a lot of advisors. We hear that millennials are too busy Snapchatting, Ubering, or Tindering while living in their helicopter parents' basements to amass any assets. And even if they did, they'd just let a robot manage them. But millennials aren't the generation you think they are. Did you know that millennials are the largest living generation today? They're bigger than baby boomers and making up about 30% of the US population. And they do have assets, $7 trillion to be exact, in liquid assets projected by 2019. And they stand to inherit a big chunk of the $30 trillion wealth transfer from their baby boomer parents. Just who are millennials anyway? The oldest among them are now in their mid-30s, entering their prime earning years and a stage when financial planning becomes important, when marriage, home buying, and children start to come into the picture. A robot can't answer their questions. Millennials also came of age during the tech collapse and the 2008 financial crisis, and they tend to see taking a risk as a losing bet. They're more risk-averse than even their parents. Half of them say they're very conservative, compared to only about a third of baby boomers. A robo-advisor can't help them focus on the long term and ignore short-term volatility, but a knowledgeable financial advisor can.
Winning and retaining female clients will be essential to the future of your practice. Women live longer than men and also tend to be younger than their husbands. Up to 80% of female clients leave their financial advisor following the death of their spouses. Two-thirds of women report that they feel misunderstood by their financial advisor. Women's assets are not just tied to inheritance. Studies show that assets held by women have been increasing, and that trend is more pronounced in younger women. Today, women hold more college degrees than men and make up nearly half of millionaires. Advisors who can offer solutions that appeal to women can capture business for decades to come.
So, how do you get impact exposure in your clients' portfolios? The investment options on the market today have exploded in recent years, and it can be hard to keep up. In episode 5, we'll break down new developments on the impact investing product scene.
Feel free to contact AP's relationship management team if you have any questions. Click yes when prompted for a free demographic review of your book of business. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next video in the series.